thank you. A few years ago, I created a character called Gary the Strange. He was a kind of new romantic pop star, but set in the modern day. And people really liked it, you know, they responded to it. I got good press and got awards and things and lots of work out of it, and it was great. And I had a couple of years, it was the best time of my life. And after a while, you sort of, you know, you've gone through everything that you can with the new romantic kind of genre, and you've suddenly run out of ideas writing songs about dandies and harlequins and robots and tower blocks and ballerinas and the colour grey and what else did I do? I didn't do Highwayman, but so maybe I missed a trick there. Eventually you just get to this point where you think, well, yeah, I like the character, but maybe I can kind of make him, you know, sort of do other styles of music like David Bowie or Scott Walker or Captain Beefheart or something like that. So I just thought I'll go with it. You know, I'll take the makeup off. I'll dress him in a suit and I'll write a concept album about birth and death and children and scarecrows and meat. And Beef Scarecrow, and then pay £8,000 to take it to Edinburgh, and have five people walk out every day, which when you've got an audience of 10 is half the audience. And somehow I expected this thing. In fact, the comedy website Chalkwalk actually described it when I did my Edinburgh show as baffling, grandiloquent crap. Which I'm very proud of, because that's exactly what I was aiming for. So as a special treat for you, I'm going to do one of the songs that I wrote for that show, and you're going to love it. In fact, it's even better than that, because this was one of the songs that wasn't even good enough to go in the show. Martin likes it too. So we're going to try this out tonight and see how it works. This is called Shivering in the Rain.
Sure. laser-guided rocket launcher type thing.
Thank you very much.